Alright, hey guys, I'm Alex from technoclass.com and this is the Star Mobile Icon. We're going to check this out today. It's a 4.5 inch QHD quad core device. The thing is, this is not a MediaTek processor. This is a Qualcomm MSM8225Q, which is slightly different. Anyway, it's got a quad core processor as mentioned and 4.5 inch Dragon Trail QHD display. 8 megapixel camera on the back with a 5 megapixel front with autofocus. So that's an interesting take on the camera phone, sort of a taking pictures of yourself, quote unquote, selfie. So yeah, 1 gigabyte of RAM and stuff like that. We're gonna check it out. Stay tuned. And here we go, we're looking at the Star Mobile Icons box, and as typical with Star Mobile, the box comes off from the top, which is nice because it won't fall off when you grab the box. Anyway, this is the phone, it right here, encased in a little bit of a plastic thing. Let's take off this paper because it's Dragon Trail. We don't need any protection, I guess. Well, we do need it sometimes, but there you go, that's the phone right here. Let's look for the battery. That's the take off the top right here. This looks like a free silicone case, which we'll look at later. And let's just look for the battery for now. This is the battery right here, and let's pop the back off and put the battery on. All right, so looking inside here, we have two SIM slots right here, regular size SIM slots, and a micro SD slot, which already has a 4 gigabyte card. So you do get a 4 gigabyte card free already when you buy the Star Mobile Icon. Now the battery is 1800 milliamp hours, so it's not super big, but it's pretty decent size. And let's pop the back on like so. Let's turn it on and look at the other parts of the box. Leave that there. And this is a Icon quick guide. And just a quick guide, not a quick start guide apparently. It's got some pictures and I think it's in black and white. There you go. This is a warranty card, a free screen protector, which is nice because you can still protect the Dragon Trail display with a bit of a cleaner and a plier thing in there. And over here we have a USB headset with a button microphone thingamajig. One piece headset. Over here we have a micro USB cable for charging and data transfer. A little bit thick on that cable. And this is a Star Mobile branded USB charger wall socket. Interesting design right there. And that is it for the box. Let's check out the phone right now. Alright guys, so here is the Star Mobile Icon itself, and it's running Android 4.1 Jelly Bean. It's not the latest, but it's still pretty good. Still relatively recent. It's running, like I said, Android 4.1, and before we look at the interface, we're gonna look at some of its physical features. So let's turn off the display here. This is a 4.5 inch QHD IPS Dragon Trail display. So that's a lot of words. That just means it's a pretty nice display, although I have to say it's a little bit more recessed underneath the screen than usual, but it's not a big deal. The screen, the viewing angles are still fine. Over here on top is probably the 5 megapixel autofocus camera, which is probably one of the biggest selling points of the Icon. And somewhere hidden in there is the proximity sensor and light sensitivity sensor. There's a little bit of a dirt there. All right, there's also a LED notification light in there that we can't see because it's not on right now. There is a speaker grill right there, 3 capacitive buttons on the bottom, and the front is pretty much dominated by a big black bezel. It's not the best size of bezel out there, but it's not bad at all. Over on the left side, there is an interesting, not volume rocker. There's a volume up and a volume down button, but it's not a rocker, which is interesting. This is also similar to the power button on top, which is an interesting sort of a design there, rib design. I don't really know what to call it, but it's a nice design. 3.5 millimeter headset jack over on the left area there. And over on the right, we have nothing. On the bottom, we have a micro USB port for charging and data transfer, and your pinhole microphone for hearing your talkie talks. This is the nub where you can open the back, and I think that's about it for the sides. Over in the back, we have the red Star Mobile logo, because apparently red means quad core. This is a speaker grill right there, and as you can see, a logo that says 8 megapixel autofocus camera with BSI. And this is the camera module itself with a LED flash. It sticks out just a little bit, but not too much. Now the design is a little okay, but it's a little thick for my tastes. And I did notice a little bit of creaking here and there, but it's not bad. Still a pretty good design, pretty good colors and textures here and there. So I guess that's it for the parts. Let's check out the case that came with it, the silicone case. And it's a fairly straightforward silicone case. You just ply it around the sides and there it goes. I'm not a big fan of the fit though. I think it should fit a little more snug, but it's not. It's still a pretty good grip though, and it's a nice, all the ports are available to use, and as even the buttons are still very clicky despite the silicone casing, as you can see right there. So yeah, that's about it. That is the parts and the case thingamajig. Let's check out the interface of the Star Mobile icon.
Subscribe to the Big Time Show.
The Big Time Show, live YouTube tech discussions every Saturday. All right, so here we are checking out the interface of the Star Mobile icon. Like I mentioned before, this is running Android 4.1 Jelly Bean, which doesn't give us the two-finger swipe on top, but it does give us a little bit of a different notification area right here with a little bit of a sort of ambient information, CPU and Wi-Fi and stuff like that. And if you press this button here, it gives you a different sort of a notification, sort of a settings area. We can change the brightness and stuff. I'll change that to full brightness and stuff like that. So that's the notification area. Here is the interface. It's still the same sort of ice cream sandwich, side swiping home screen, and a button here on the bottom gets you to the application drawer and widgets. One thing I noticed is that you have to hit the widgets area to move on to the widgets part. Sort of makes it a little bit harder to add your widgets to your screen, but it's not a big deal. So yeah, it's a pretty nice interface. Quad-core processor. The Qualcomm MSM8225Q is handling things fairly well. It also has a 1 GB of RAM, 4 GB of ROM, with obviously a micro SD slot to it, and it came with a 4 GB card free. And yeah, fairly usable interface. No noticeable lags, especially on the interface itself. So let's take a quick look at the camera for now. All right, so here we are checking out the camera of the Star Mobile icon, and it's a rather different sort of interface here. I believe this was used by some Android versions, and if you hold the button right here, it gives you quick access to some of the menus, which is sort of interesting. It's sort of quick, but sometimes sort of clumsy as well if you don't know what you're doing. It's pretty good either way though. One thing I noticed is that it's using the entire screen as your viewfinder, but it takes 4x3 pictures, 8 megapixels, so you're actually taking a picture that has more top and bottom, which you don't see, which is kind of interesting. So yeah, settings right there, you take videos as well. 8 megapixel BSI camera, you can take 720p video, and by the way, the camera is pretty excellent. The 5 megapixel camera in front with autofocus is not bad as well. So pretty good camera. I would say it's actually even better than some 12 megapixel or 8 megapixel cameras out there. So that's what I'm gonna tell you right now. So yeah, let's move on. Alright, so here we are playing a game of Temple Run Oz, and run on the Star Mobile icon obviously. And it runs fairly well. I'm using this on a highest quality level. I don't know why it's defaulted to that. Maybe it's because of the Qualcomm processor. I think you can get probably a better frame rate if you lower the quality a little bit. But even at this, the highest quality imaginable on the Temple Run Oz, it's still fairly playable. And as you can see, swipes and taps do not lag and does not take any sort of a input lag as well. So there you go, that's Temple Run Oz. Fairly playable on the Star Mobile icon. Alright guys, so here we are checking out Asphalt 7. It's a fairly normal gaming test for us here in the Techno class, I guess. And game runs actually very smooth. I think it is Qualcomm processors, the MSM8 225Q. Renders Asphalt 7 much better than MediaTek 865, 89. I'm sorry for giving you so many numbers. But I think the Qualcomm processor is handling Asphalt 7 fairly good, fairly well. So if you like Asphalt 7 or maybe a little bit of gaming, the Qualcomm processor probably is for you. All right, so one last game before we finish here. Spider-Man is on the case. All right, guys, so here we are playing The Amazing Spider-Man. I guess this is a recent Spidey-Man release, whatever. And actually just, this game is so weird. So this is a fairly demanding game, and there's a lot of skyscrapers and stuff like that. There's an airplane flying about, so you might hear that on the audio. This is a very demanding game, though I think the Qualcomm processor is handling it fine. I'm terrible at spidying? Is that a word? Spidying? But this game looks fairly good and fairly playable. So congratulations on the Star Mobile Icon for handling the Amazing Spider-Man. There you go. Alright guys, so I think that's about it for the Star Mobile Icon. I think it's a good mixture of a little bit of a gaming capabilities and a little bit of the camera capabilities, which is an interesting sort of a mixture here and there, because obviously most of the time you get just a good camera, bad gaming, or maybe a good gaming, not so good camera, or whatever. So this is a quad-core Qualcomm processor with the 8 megapixel and the 5 megapixel in front. A little bit of the pros and cons here and there. So definitely pros are the great camera quality, which I will show to you at the near the end of the video. Good front camera as well. Decent gaming capabilities, as I've shown before. I like the LED notification light. That's quickly becoming resurgent in today's phones. And the free silicone case, free screen protector, and 4GB SD card is also quite a bonus. Now, the downsides, though, is one, the silicone case doesn't really fit right. I mean, it fits, but it usually falls off sometimes when you pull it out of your pocket. My notice is that just a little bit of gaming gets warm over use, and it's warm right now. And the 1800 milliamp hour battery is not a long lasting battery. It probably gives you maybe 12 hours or so. Under my average use, your use could be different. And my typical phone, my average use is, on other phones I would get about 14-15 hours. I did notice a little bit of creakiness on some of the case. I don't know if, it turned off. A little bit of the creakiness on the case right here as well. So I guess that's about it. I don't know what happened. It rebooted. Maybe we can say that's a crash. That is the Star Mobile Icon. This priced at, I forgot to tell you the price, it's 7,990. So about 8,000 pesos. Boots up really quickly, by the way. 8,000 pesos. Fairly decent if you're looking for a quad-core phone with good gaming capabilities and good cameras. The 8 megapixel camera is really impressive, actually. So yeah, that's about it. Star Mobile Icon, check it out. I'm gonna give it 3.5 stars out of 5. I'm Alex from technoclass.com. Thanks for watching. Alright guys, thanks for watching, and as always, if you liked the video, please press the like button below. Add it to your favorites and or share it to your friends. If you got something to say, drop a comment in the comment box as well. Of course, more importantly, you should hit the subscribe button on top. This will keep you up to date with our new uploads and helps us out tremendously too. That's it guys, see you next video.